Chapter 6, Nostalgic Nocturne. McBain says, "Man, this is the capital city of a country? There's nothing left to see." "It's strange," says Una. "It seems like there were very few people killed, even with damage as great as this." "But Necros and Emperor Rousen lost their lives," says McBain. Arya says, "I suspect that the Dark Sun responded to people that emitted strong negative notions and tried to absorb them." "I should have called it negative emotions." "Negative notion?" says Ada. "It's negative human emotions that infest the world, such as despair, hatred, greed, and destructive urges." Ada says, "I guess the lightning struck those people who didn't think good things." "Hey," says Thomas. "Even in Milo with them, even in Milo gonna meet all of us, that's amazing." Forte says, "Thomas." "It's Mitchell, too," says Una. "And?" Avon says, "Yo, are you okay?" Una says, "Oh, you're that guy we met in Cavaro." "Yeah, very briefly." "He's the one that helped us when we escaped Cavaro with Arya," says Forte. "Oh, you noticed us, huh?" says Mile. "I'm surprised you knew under such circumstance." Forte says, "I'll never forget that boomerang. I thought it was over when we were surrounded by numerous soldiers. The boomerang saved us." I had no idea these guys are all going to meet and talk. That's something about that is amazing to me. Let me introduce them," says Mitchell. "This is Avon and Mile." Thomas says, "These two are the saviors I was talking about before." "Hello, I'm Mile. Pleased to meet you." "I'm Avon. Pleased to meet you too." "Mile took all the honor at Cavaro, so I wanted to show up at a good time, but I got involved in the release of Cavaro. Mayor DeMille and Ms. Meritos simply wouldn't let me go." "That's awesome. We had no idea that the Dark Sun was like this," says Mile. "Then was it you guys that freed Cavaro?" asked Forte. "We just helped a little," Avon said. "A little?" says Una. "You're being modest, aren't you?" "You're not like Grandpa at all," says Forte. Mile says, "Mr. McBain and his friends are much more powerful. They freed the entire Numeros Empire." "Yeah, that's right," says McBain. "See? You're not modest at all," says Forte. McBain says, "But we can't afford to be joking around." "Yes," says Mitchell. "We saw it when we were on the boat. It flew over to Burrowdean. It seemed like it was being controlled or something." "Sir Ector," says a voice. "Who knows my name?" says Palman. "Well, one of your names. Captain Naressa?" "Sir Ector, I'm glad you're okay," says the captain. "You knew about me?" Palman says. "Yes, I used to work for your father. I knew who you were, Sir Ector, right when I saw you, but I pretended not to, in order to keep you out of danger." "Darn," says McBain. "Then you already knew about our plan." "Then," Forte says, "you gave the orders to make it easier for us to walk around on purpose, didn't you?" Palman says, "You ordered me to work in the kitchen so that people won't notice me very much, then." Captain says, "When I heard that Cleta was freed, I thought perhaps that Sir Ector was involved. I believed you would not let Numeros' malicious activities go unpunished, especially since you share the spirit of your father. Here, this is for you. I removed this from the wooden soldier." "Oh, the stone. This is the Quagmire Resonance Stone," says Palman. "If you think about it," says the captain, "you can say that Numeros has followed the muddy path after your father's death. And there's one more thing. This is the Love Resonance Stone that was given to me by your father." "The Love Resonance Stone?" Una says, "What? Another Resonance Stone?" "I see," says McBain. "We didn't notice it because Captain Naressa was in the same location as the Quagmire Resonance Stone." "Okay. The Love Resonance Stone was given to your father by Sir Leone." "Father had the Resonance Stone?" says Palman. The captain says, "While on his journey to conceal the Resonance Stone, Sir Leone was touched by the love that your father gave to people. he entrusted the resonance stone of love to him. On this resonance stone, the words, "May the power of love be home to those that show love," are engraved. Huh. I wonder what it does, because we already have a healing. I didn't think it would be healing, but... Your late father handed me this, telling me to give it to anyone who displayed a strong sense of love. I believe that I saw that love in Ektor and his party as they tried to save Arya, no matter how much danger they might be in. Please, please accept this. Palmon received the resonance stone. He says, "My deceased father's thoughts. I'm going to entrust this resonance stone to Mr. McBain. Mr. McBain, please accept this. I'd be honored." Forte and his friends obtain the resonance stone of Quagmire. And love. "Sir Ektor, please give me your order," says the captain. Oh. Is Palmon above him? "Rousen has fallen. You're now the leader of the new Numeros." Really? "Captain Naressa," he says, "I have no desire to be the leader of a country." Captain says, "Sir Ektor." Palmon says, "It's not the royalty that will rebuild Numeros. The country is for everyone that lives here. Of course, I will support making Numeros a good country that is not an embarrassment to the world. So I'd like you to do away with the notion of bloodlines. Please think that the person named Ektor is no longer. I am Palmon. I'm just a man that cares about this country and the world." Mitchell says, "It seems a newly reborn Numeros is emerging from the ashes of its old regime." So cool. Avon says, "The problem is the Dark Sun. It flew towards Buridane, but we can't just leave it alone." Thomas says, "What do you think about the current condition of the Dark Sun?" Mitchell says, "It seems like the clump of harmful frequency that makes up the Dark Sun has awakened and started resonance activity because of Numeros' experiments. I think we can assume that it has become active." "Can't we stop it?" asks Forte. "It seems like we still need that song," McBain says. "The water melody," says Forte. McBain says, "As the leader of Shulf said, the resonance stones that we have been searching for are the keys." Forte says, "But there are a total of 24 of them. We need to find 3 more or we can't make the song." "We've been searching for the resonance stones all over," says McBain. "The only place we haven't searched is Buridane. I think it's safe to assume that the remaining 3 are there." "In any case, let's hurry to Buridane," says Forte. "We must find the remaining resonance stones and complete the water melody." Una says, "But even if you collect all the resonance stones and understand the phrase, we still won't know the structure of the water melody." "That's true," says McBain. "We have no idea how to place the phrases to play the music." Arya says, "I hear that there's a vessel of water tribe origin that has been passed down in Buridane." "A vessel?" says Mitchell. "The technique is passed on in Shulf. This is the technique for performing the resonant spells. I have no idea what the vessel is, though." McBain says, "It seems like we can find out about it once we get to Buridane." "There's a possibility that the remaining resonance stones aren't in Buridane," says Thomas. "If that's the case, it's better to travel by sea. I'll travel across the ocean on the Planetos too." Mitchell says, "I'll travel on my own because I have a few places that I want to visit." "Yeah, Grandpa Lap, you do that. There are some things that I want to confirm regarding the Dark Sun. I'll join Thomas before the Planetos 2 arrives at the port of Grabadel, so don't worry." Forte says, "You plan on joining a boat that is traveling across the ocean?" Avon says, "Mr. Mitchell can go anywhere if he's alone." "Well, not quite anywhere," Mitchell says. "Oh, that thing we saw at Shulf?" says Una. "Yeah, that," says Forte. "Teleportation, huh?" McBain says. Avon says, "Then Mile and I will head towards Buridane by land with Forte. Let's meet up in Grabadel." Spelled it wrong. "We don't know what's going on in Buridane," says McBain. They may make the mistake of thinking that Numeros is invading them if Mr. Palmon arrives with his soldiers. Let's have Mr. Palmon stay in Numeros. It's better to prepare recovery for the people that live here anyway, right?" "Mr. McBain," says Palmon, Thank you for your help. I'll join you after we finish the preparations for the rebuild. Okay, McBain says. We'll try to get a handle on things before then. And Ada. Huh? She says. We successfully rescued Arya. Go ahead and do what you're planning on doing. What she plans to do? Says Forte. Ha ha ha, I can't hide anything from you, Mr. Mac. I'm old and wise, he says. There's something I want to do. I want to go back to Gazalg and heal Capri and Pedro. I have parts that the Gazalg Elder gave me, and if I use Grandma Croto's yarn, I think I can heal them. It might take some time, though. Go ahead and do that, says McBean. It's too sad to leave Capri and Pedro the way they are. Oh, yeah, huh? Says Forte. Una says, Ada, you have another reason for wanting to stay. Ada just says, thanks, everyone. What about you, Miss Arya? Asks Forte. Of course, I'll go to Buridane with everyone. Miss Arya, it seems as though you have an enormous mission to accomplish, says McBean. I was prepared for this at the time I was given this power. Let's go, onward to Buridane. My mission is to calm the Dark Sun. Arya, Pullman says. McBean says, well, we go separate ways from here. Forte says, Ada, I'll see you later. Okay, I'm sorry about this. I'm sorry I can't go to Buridane. Thanks for joining us this far, says Forte. You've been a great help. I hope Capri and Pedro get healed soon, says Una. Yeah, you guys be careful too, Ada says. Arya, says Pullman. I'll be leaving soon. Don't overexert yourself, okay? You're very important for this world right now, and for me as well. Pullman, oh, I got a thing for her, I thought so. Your mission as a priestess may be very important, says Pullman, but... Silence fell between the two. Pullman, thank you. Well, shall we go? Says Thomas. Woof! Whoa, says Thomas. Huh? Forte says. Jan, Rick, are you going by boat? It seems they like the Planetos too, says Thomas. You can't leave us, Jan. We need your healing powers. Woof! Squeak! Well, it'll be hard to move around if we have too many members, so it's all good, says McBean. We need healings. Don't cause any trouble, got it? I mean, this is our main healer, even though I have Una, because the way Jan just goes so quickly, he's usually the first one to go in a round. So this might make things a little trickier. Oh, he's trying to get that heal in before the enemy attacks. Well, let's go then, says McBean. I'll check for damage in the nearby areas and catch up with you after recovery has started. I'm sorry. You don't have to apologize, says McBean. Say hello to Rosette for me. Okay. Be careful, everyone. We will, says Forte. It was fun traveling with you, says Una. Let's meet again sometime. Hehe. Thanks, Una. We'll meet again sometime, won't we? Of course. I'm sorry that I can't be of any help when things are just getting started. If I only had a doll. Shall we look around before we go? I assume we're going out the west entrance. Speak. We'll recover Numeros so that it's peaceful and plentiful like before. Numeros will no longer be an evil empire that threatens other countries. It'll be okay since Sir Ector, I mean, Mr. Pullman, is with us. Where'd he come up with that name, Ector? I'm worried about Buridane. Leave this up to us. Mr. McBain, please head over to Buridane.
Oh, you're a poet. Didn't even know it.
Let's see how the other townspeople are faring. Yeah, this place has seen better days. The Dark Sun flew to Buridan as if it had a mind of its own. I wonder if they're okay? He's back at his post. How dare you abandon your post, you maggot? Recovery would take too long if we spread out too much, so we're sealing this area off. After recovering the residences, the plan is to gradually spread out the recovery process. Mm-hmm. Okay. Can we still go this way? Yeah. Well, that bridge is out, I'm sure, still. I want to see if there's anything interesting at the battleground. So that was supposed to be, like, a crucifix. It just looked like a giant sword. And I thought that's what it was. I'm like, wow, that's a big King Arthur to be pulling out that sword. Yeah, those things were tough. We fought them there. Trying to see if... No, okay. So I guess all those researchers died too, huh? No one cares about them. How sad. Forte has heavy footfalls. Even in Mile, I can't believe we met them and all talking and stuff. That's kind of amazing. I didn't think that would happen. I thought the characters never met. But in this one, they do. Mmm. That armor. Maybe we can get that armor. There's an inn at the checkpoint at the border with Buridan. Please stay there if you need to. Please leave Pucasas to us. We'll divide up and make sure we recover. Mm-hmm.
Rose died, huh? I guess he got what he deserved. Now this country will be reborn as a good country.
Everyone calls him Palmin, but I heard that he's actually Sir Ector. Wait, what did he say? Numeros will be okay as long as Sir Ector is here. Numeros will become a good country. Hmm. A good country. My good country, tis of thee. Exchange. Wow. I don't know why this stuff has to be so expensive. Any other new weapons? Wire glove! Oh my god, for Mr. McBain. Can't even buy it. Don't have enough money. Iron shield, sheet armor. It was the knight armor I wanted. Does Arya have knight armor? Even? Oh, what? They're in the party. Even and Mile, I did not realize this. Yeah, because I was kind of like figuring they went off somewhere. We'll find them, like, maybe in the castle, hanging out. They're in the party. That's crazy. That's awesome. Okay, so Aven already has a knight sword, knight shield, and knight armor. Mile has the chakram boomerang and knight shield, knight armor. So, have to see who suits our purposes, though, as far as battle. Oh, she has this stuff. Awakening. A spell cast from the phrase of love. Recovers one ally from unconsciousness. She's got recovery. Releases one ally from the effect of the spell cast by the purification phase. Detoxifies one ally. Heals one ally completely. All revive. Heals all allies moderately. Alright, so I want Arya in the party, I believe. I don't know why they call it revive. It makes me think that it's a resurrection kind of, you know, bring you back kind of thing. Aven's got black magic. Aqua Rip, a spell handed down in Elfilden, launches water balls to damage one enemy. Well, we've seen that in this game too, though. A spell handed, tornado, shining bullets. Damages one enemy locked in a space. Raises the agility of one ally. And then finishing moves, you got the strike force. A full force blow cuts off the enemy. The blade damages the surrounding enemies. And for skills, he's got taunt. Might up. Heat up. Spends time concentrating and the power gauge. Double attack, a series of attacks including both high and low strikes. Brave up, calms the soul, healing both mind and body. Okay. And Mile heals one ally. Okay, he's another healer. Heals one ally completely, heals all moderately. Detoxifies, releases one ally from frozen state, releases one ally from unconsciousness. And confusion. Confuses one enemy. Makes one enemy immobile. Bind. And for finishing moves, he has flamethrow. A quick spinning flame boomerang attacks the enemy. And steel throw. Uses the boomerang to swipe items from the enemy. And freeze throw. Strikes at the feet of the enemy, hindering movement. Kind of like a quagmire resonance stone does, huh? Okay. Soul voice. Arya's got a singing voice that rocks the soul. Those interfering sustain damage. Charity. An enveloping heart of charity raises the effect of recovery. I wonder if that's like a regeneration kind of thing. A resonance spell. Right. This is. I looked at these. Alright. So we have three healers available. Una, Mile, and Arya. Does it make Aven and Mile? So I think we'll leave Forte and McBain. We'll take out Una. Yeah, I'm gonna do, okay. Okay, so we have Forte, McBain, Aven, and Mile. Nice. And the bonus is that they already have this stuff. What am I in? Sell or buy? Alright, so the knight sword he has. So okay, we're gonna sell. No, I was right. I was in the right menu. I have to de-equip this. I'm gonna sell the bear glove, so we have enough money to buy the other glove. Selling bear glove. Buying. Wire glove. There you go. So he's all up to date, at least as far as that. So we still need the knight armor for Forte and McBain. Well, Una's left the party for now. Well, she's gonna hang around and just watch, I guess. Arya's already got it. Aven and Mile already have it. So I can optionally grind and get the armor. Maybe I will. Hey you! I mean, ladies and gents. I heard that you weren't just a newbie. You had me fooled. Sorry. Everyone's a newbie at some point. Leave Pucasas to us. I can say this now that it's over, but I was thinking that I can't agree with Emperor Rousen. Countries that try to take over the world with fear aren't very popular anymore. When were they? You're Arya? Wow, you're so beautiful. Creepy. Hey, you guys. I'm surprised. You guys were heroes. I'm sorry about treating you like a newbie. It's okay. We trying to pass ourselves off as a newbie, so no issue there. You able to cook in all this mess? Man, I was surprised that Palmin was Sir Ector. I haven't seen him at Pucasas, so I was wondering what he was doing. I didn't know he changed his name. I didn't even notice it when he was working here. I wonder if I was rude to him? It's kind of things you think about later. Like, how did I treat him? What did I say? Oh, wow. I'm gonna talk to them last. I don't even know who that is talking to the captain. Just curious. So I'll check down here to see if anything's changed. That looks like an entrance, but it's not. It is not. This is when you can come back and get the resonance stone if you didn't already. I mean, orb of ocean. I'm surprised you can't even say these are locked anymore, they just don't even respond. Oh yeah, this guy still left this post. No one cares about the data center anymore. Who's that? Captain Gazelle? Our boat got stranded during a mission. We came back, risking punishment, but I had no idea things were like this. I asked Captain Palmer to call me before he does anything. He's such a stranger sometimes. But Numeros will be reborn. I'll help Captain Palmer to help rebuild Numeros. The Navy will be helping with the rebuilding. We're okay now. Please, be careful. Okay. The door doesn't respond. Hmm. I was thinking of grinding back that way, but we can grind this way, can't we? Alright, heading towards birding next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.